In part 4 of our series, we look at market value and dividend ratios. So these ratios are more driven by the market and also of concern to investors. Generally, market value ratios answer the question of how does the market or investors view the company's financial prospects. One measure is earnings per share, and that is the amount of net income for each outstanding share of common stock, calculated by taking net income divided by the number of outstanding common shares. Earnings per share obtained from Reuters is a TTM number, trailing 12 months, so it uses the most recent 12 months of data available. The earnings per share for Microsoft was $2.59, and Apple, $40.04. What everyone looks to see with earnings per share is improvement over time. We like to see earnings per share go up. It's difficult to see too much just from this number. For example, can we say Apple is better than Microsoft? Not necessarily. It depends on number of shares. The second ratio, PE ratio, is where we really put market value ratios to work. This is the amount per share that investors are willing to pay per $1 of earnings. So this is a relative indication of value. The price per share is divided by earnings per share. So for Microsoft, we saw a PE of 12.77, which means that for every dollar of earnings, investors are willing to pay $12.77. Apple has a PE of 12.01. Is a higher ratio better? Well, that really depends. If you are a value investor, then you are looking for a low PE ratio that might indicate that a stock is undervalued and a good buy. In companies in hot industries such as 3D printing and other internet technology type industries, for example, a Twitter, maybe coming out soon with an IPO, may have a very high PE ratio, indicating that investors think that in the future they will have very good growth. They may have very low earnings at this point. So sometimes investors are looking for a lot of growth, in which case a company may interest them that has a very high PE. Other times they may be looking for a value company with a lower ratio. This is primarily used by investors and analysts. Another market value ratio is the market to book value, which compares the market price of the share of stock by the book value per share. Book value is an accounting measure and basically takes the assets from the accounting records minus liabilities from the accounting records or financial statements, which gives us the book value per share, once you divide it by the number of common shares. Microsoft and Apple both had market to book values in that 3.5 range. This is sometimes used by investors to indicate a company that is undervalued. Sometimes if the market value drops below book value, that might mean that you could break up the company and sell it for more than it is worth as a company altogether. Sixth type of ratios is dividend ratios, and they answer the question, does the company pay a dividend? And if so, what do they pay? The dividend yield answers the question, if I invest today, what can I expect to earn in dividends on my investment? So the dividend yield takes the dividend that the company is currently paying per share and divides it by the current market price per share. So if I bought Microsoft on October 9th, I would expect to earn as dividends 3.4% on what I invest. On Apple, I would expect to earn about 2.5% on what I invest. Now, is a higher ratio better or a lower ratio worse? Well, it depends on what you're looking for. If you are looking for a steady stream of dividends versus what you can get for interest on the market versus a growth stock, then you would want to see a higher ratio, as long as you consider that the company is not too risky. You will see companies that do not pay any dividend. Prior to 2012, Apple never paid a dividend. Google doesn't pay a dividend. These are growth companies. Google, Amazon, I believe, does not pay a dividend. Not positive. They are reinvesting all of their earnings into the company, and the investors in those companies expect to earn their money by the increase in share value. So whether there is a dividend or not, whether that is good or bad, depends on what an investor is looking for. The dividend payout ratio measures the percentage of earnings that are paid out in dividends to the common shareholders. So we take dividends divided by net income. Currently, Microsoft is paying out 35% of net income as dividends. So they are returning 35% to the shareholders. Apple currently returning 27%. Google currently returning 0%. Is a high dividend payout good or bad? Again, it depends on what you're looking for.